First thing to know about Process Book is it has two modes. There's a run mode and a build mode, characterized by this little icon here. So if I switch over to our application, yeah, here's our build mode, here's run mode. Let's go over run mode real briefly. Run mode is what you would use by default to do things like launch new displays. So for example, if I double click this in run mode, it's going to go ahead and launch that main column bottom display. Likewise, if I were to grab this and drag it over here, that's going to launch a display. And then once on that display, you'll find that, let me bring this my main column up here. Yeah, once I'm on this display, you can use in run mode, you can use this to do different things for viewing sake. So for example, I can double click on this and it will expand it to the size that is, you know, that it might be more convenient to look at. So I can zoom in. This is all something I'm doing in run mode. Now let's contrast that with build mode. Okay. Let me switch over to build mode. I'll close this out. While in build mode, if I were to double click on this, instead of launching it, it's going to allow me to modify this. And then likewise, if I were to go ahead and open this up, I can choose new. That will open it up just as though I were in run mode. Anyway, I could have either done that by choosing new or choosing run mode and then double clicking. But anyway, when I am in build mode and I start double clicking on individual elements like this, remember when I double clicked in run mode, it expanded. When I double click in build mode, it brings up the builder dialog box for that particular object. Now there are a host of other things that you would, you know, as you would imagine, you would find in run mode versus build mode. In run mode, for example, I can do these so-called ad hoc trends by choosing, let me show you an example, by choosing a trend object while I've also chosen an item in here. So by choosing this, I can do an ad hoc of whatever I've chosen. That's something that you would find in run mode that you would not find in build mode. Also, just to be thorough here, let me point out that you can go into run mode by choosing tools run or build mode by tools build. So there's a couple of different ways of getting into run mode versus build mode. Also in run mode, when I click on an object and try to drag it, nothing happens. If I'm in build mode, click on an object, try to drag it, well, you drag the object. So let me undo that with a Control-Z. So that's briefly run mode versus build mode.